السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام.
الحمد
لله. Can you guys see my screen?
Yes.
Yes.
All right, let's just wait for couple of minutes so everybody can join, and then inshallah we'll take it from there. Okay, so the material I sent over the weekend, do you guys find it useful?
Yes, useful.
Very good.
Jazakallah khair, I'm glad a bit.
Wa'ayyakum, wa'ayyakum, inshallah. So I guess learning a lot of stuff, maybe vocabulary and all that. And are you guys using those the tools I have been suggesting? Right, the tools.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you, Arfa?
Alhamdulillah. And yes, I've been using the Corpus Quran website regularly. Alhamdulillah, it's really helpful.
So does it help you? Do you get inside information?
Yes, I mostly use it for the shorter surahs, the ones, you know, we usually recite in our salah. Uh-huh. So that really helps us a lot as well. I can understand what I'm trying to do.
Okay. All right. What's the time? Channel 2. Okay, inshallah. We'll start, and as people join us, they can start to, you know, practice or participate with us. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
السلام عليكم brother Abid. Sorry to interrupt you right in the beginning. While we are going through mashallah the lecture, last lecture, mm-hmm. if we can do a quick review on that. I know you do it normally, but requesting that specially because I think
inshallah.
I missed a couple of things, you know.
Okay, no, I'm going to do that right now, inshallah.
Okay, salam alaikum. Jazakallah khair.
So, since today is our, fifth class? Almost fifth class, I think. Class number 5? Or more, maybe? But let's say class number 5. Class number 5. Okay. So, before I change the topic, I want to do a complete review of what we have done in the last 3 sessions. Okay. And the reason is that inshallah, if we nail this subject down, if we get it 100%, then moving forward, it will be a slam dunk. Like we don't have to worry about it. So inshallah, let's focus on this one more time. And let's see if we understand what we have done so far. So what we have done so far is the following. We said this part of speech are 3. Part of speech are 3. And what are those parts? We have ism. We call it harf. And then the third one we have is the fail. Okay. Now, as of right now, I don't have to explain this, what this is, right? Can I confidently say that you, every one of you understand this, right?
Alhamdulillah.
Okay. So then when we started, we focus on ism first. If you want the English names for these, this is known as noun. This is particle. And this is verb. Okay, we said ism has 4 characteristics. and we know them. We know they are gender, number, capacity, and status. Okay. By now, we know the gender in Arabic is known as jins. Yes. Number is known as adad. Now, people from Pakistan or India who speak Urdu, they know what adad means. Right? Capacity is wusat. And the status is halat. Okay? We know the gender could only be male and female. Okay? And when we talk about adad, we know that we're talking about singular, dual, and plural. Okay, in the wusat, we want to know if it's a definite or indefinite. In simple terms, is it a common noun or it's a proper noun? Okay. And halat, we know there are three statuses: rafa, nasab, and jar. Okay. Please tell me which one of you or any one of you is still not clear about these things. It's okay to say it because we are still in the learning phase, so I don't expect everyone to know everything 100%, but it would be nice to know that what is your level of understanding at this point. This much we should be able to understand.
Alhamdulillah, so far that's fine, yeah.
Okay. Anybody else? Brother Abdul is, mashallah, very confident.
Yeah, I'm good with it.
Sisters?
Yeah, we are good, brother.
Mashallah. Okay. So what we did last time, we took we talked about the status. And we know that in a noun at any given time can be any one of these statuses: rafa, nasab, and jar. Yes? And for that, we have the criteria. We have a criteria. We look at the haraka on last letter. And the possible harakas are dhammatan, fatatan, kasratan. Yes? In order to know the status, we need to know the number and gender. So we made groups. We said group one, we said wahid or jama mukassar. That's one group. Yes? Now, I didn't put the gender here because we know that whether it's muzakkar or muannas, the rule is the same. What is the rule? We look at the haraka on the last letter. What is the example? We took the example. We said muslimun, musliman, muslimin. Last letter is meem. Rafa is dhammatan. Nasab is fatatan. And jar is kasratan. Is anybody has question about this?
No.
No. Okay, good. In group two, we have Musanna. Now, the rule is same for male or female. So I'm not putting the male and female. The rule is ending sound. Okay, what does that mean? Rafa is ani sound, which means if I have something like Muslim, I can go and I can say Muslima ni. That means two Muslim men. And that is Rafa. Ani sound. So ending sound. Ani. How do I write it? Ani. Maybe like that. Ani sound. Okay. Nasab and Jar is Aini sound. So meaning Muslimaini. Muslimaini. So how do I want you to understand this? That a noun can only have three statuses. Rafa, Nasab, and Jar. In order to determine those statuses, you need to look at the number and the gender. Based on the number, we made group one, group two, and we said group one is Wahid and Jama Mukassar because the haraka on the last letter can tell me the status of that noun. Versus in group two, Musanna, if there is an ani sound, it's a rafa. If it's an aini sound, then it's nasab and jar. Okay? Group three, is Jama Salim. In this case, we have to look at the gender, which is like Muzakkar and Muannas. Why? Because in the Rafa, it's going to be the Una sound. U-na. And in Nasab and Jar, it's going to be Ina sound. So, Ina. How do I say it? E-na. Again, ending sound. Example is Muslimu na, Muslimi na, Muslimi na. Okay? When it comes to Muannas, we have A tun for the rafa, a tin for nasab, and a tin for jar. Okay, example Muslima tun, Muslima tin, Muslima tin. Any questions?
Brother, can you just repeat the mudakkar on the last one?
Repeat which
Muslimuna?
Yeah. Muslimina. Muslimina. Mina.
Mina.
Mina. Muslimina, Muslimina. Kafirina, okay. Kafiruna, Kafirina, Kafirina. Salehuna, Salehina, Salehina. Mominuna, Mominina, Mominina.
Okay, I had another note. That's okay. Thank you.
No, please tell me what note you have.
I had the last Muslimaina and then Muslimaina.
No, that is Ani. That's the group two, which is Musanna.
Yeah, I had it wrong. Sorry.
If I have the word Muslim, mm-hmm. and if I have to make it dual, I would say Muslimani for the rafa sound, Muslimaini, Muslimaini, Aini sound, right?
Yeah.
Ina, aini. And again, remember, we said yatim, yatimani, yatimaini, yatimaini. Jannatani, jannataini, jannataini. Okay, let's practice. Inshallah, practice it through the Quranic verses. Inshallah, you will see the meaning of that. Now, one good thing is that in Quran, the musanna has been used very little. Very, very few examples of musanna. However, wahid and the jama salim and jama mukassar is a lot. And depending on the status, you will see some place muslimuna, some place you're going to see muslimina. Now, there is another one. Sadiquna, sadiqina, sadiqina. Yes? In some verses, there are characteristics of Muslim men and Muslim women given side by side. And you will find that is probably one of them is Surah Tawbah, if I'm not wrong.
Brother, you are cutting off.
Sorry. I said there are some verses in the Quran where the qualities of both men, Muslim men and women are given, and you will find these variations in there. You will say Muslimuna wal Muslimat, you know, Mu'minina wal Mu'minat, Sadiqina wa Sadiqat. So if you read that verse, you will see, you'll find these combinations there. Okay, so this is a status. Any question on this? Well, I need to take it to the next level now. Remember, in the WhatsApp group, let me see if I can open it for you guys. And I'll share the screen. It's opening up. Okay. So let's take a look. Okay, can you guys see this?
Yes.
Okay. So, did you guys get a chance to look at these words? This is vocabulary, right?
Yes.
Now, by default, which state they are in?
Feminine?
No. Status.
Rafa.
Like, yes. Dimun, Wahidun, Alimun, Kabirun, Abdun, Salihun, Sadiqun, Khalikun, Nabiyun, Mujahidun, Baytun. Right? So if we have to take this example, or before I do that, let me go over the other one. Here you also have some other words, and here we have another list of words. So say, try to practice the rule of making dual and plural by reproducing the above table for the following words, both masculine and feminine. Now, did you guys do this exercise? Did anybody read this, that this was an exercise?
Yes.
Okay. So, we can try together. So, what we are trying to do, we are going to make a table. We're going to say muzakkar and muannas. Okay, I have to share my other screen with you guys so that you can see what I'm talking about. Okay, can you see my screen? Yes. Okay, so now I have to make it wahid. And if you haven't done this exercise already, so I'm going to give you an example of how I expect you to do it. So this chart or the way I'm doing it, please do it on your own time. So we're going to say musanna and then jama. The word is Let's say Sadiq. In Wahid, how do I know the Rafa status? Sadiq. So by default, what should be the status? Rafa. What is the Musanna status of Sadiq? Who can tell me what will be the Musanna of Sadiq?
Sadiqani.
Sadiqani. Sadiqani, right? Now, what status is this? I'm not writing the status. So, what is the status?
Rafa.
Rafa. Rafa. How do you know?
Ani sound.
Ani sound. Mashallah. Now you guys. Now we're getting somewhere. Okay. Then, is Sadiq is a quality or is it a name of something?
Quality.
What did we talk about? That when it's a quality, most likely is going to be a jama.
Jama salam.
So what is the jama of this?
Sadiqun.
MashaAllah. Now, is it Rafa or what status is this?
Rafa.
How do you know?
Una sound.
MashaAllah. See, now we are getting somewhere. So in the Wahid, you looked at the last letter, you put Dhammatan, you said Rafa. You said, okay, Sadiqani is the Rafa because of the Ani sound. Sadiquna because of the Una sound. Now, if we have to make the same thing in Nasab, what will be the Nasab of Sadiq?
Sadiqatun.
No, you're young female. Okay, I should delete that. Okay, so we are still on Muzakkar. Okay. And now this is Rafa. And I'm looking for Nasab now. So what are we going to do? Sadiqan. Why I did the Alif here?
Rafa.
Because of, this is Nasab, sorry. Nasab was Sadiqun, right? So Sadiqan and then Sadiqan. In. Because I'm going this way. So Nasab is right here and this is Jar. Making sense? What will be the Nasab of Sadiqani?
Sadiqaini.
Right? And the Nasab and Jar will be the same, right? So
Sadiqaini.
Got it? Now what about Sadiquna? What will be the Nasab of his?
Sadiqina.
Okay. Now, even though they're written the same way, but you have to remember the difference. It's Sadiqaini, Sadiqina. Aini, Ina. Sadiqaini, Sadiqina. Yes? And same thing with the Rafa is the same thing. So that's the good news that both Nasab and Jar is the same. Okay? Now, if we have to do the same thing with Monnas, what will be the Monnas of Sadiqun?
Sadiqatun.
Sadiqatun. Right? That is a Rafa. What about Nasr?
Sadiqatan.
Sadiqatan. Should I add the Alif?
No.
Why? Because it is female. Okay. Then Sadiqatin. Now, how do I know this? Because I know I'm dealing with Wahid. When I'm dealing with Wahid, I know that I have to look at the last letter and Dhammatan for Rafa and Fatatan for Nasab and Kasratan for Jar. Okay. So, what will be the Nasab in Musanna for Sadiqatun?
Sadiqatani.
Right? What will be the Nasab?
Sadiqataini.
Sadiqataini. MashaAllah. Are we making progress? Yes. Now, what will be Sadiqatun, Sadiqatani, what will be the Jama Salim?
Sadiqatun.
Sadiqatun.
Tun.
Okay. Sadiqatun.
Ten.
Ten.
And sadika
tin.
Yes. Tin. Okay. Now let's do translation. Sadikun, a truthful person. Man. A man, a truthful man. Two truthful men. Sadikuna, more than two truthful men. Sadikan, same thing. When you change the status, the meaning does not change. The only thing we change when the status is changing, that is changing from subject to object to relationship. Yes?
Right.
Now, if you do this practice with your own hand, do you think that you will master this concept? Yes? Would you master this concept if you do it by your own hand for 5-10 minutes?
Yes, exactly. Yeah.
Okay, so who is going to do it? Who can promise me that they will do this?
Inshallah, me, Fawad.
Fawad?
Inshallah.
Brother, this is Afsal here. I will do it, inshallah, too.
Okay, so let's, do you want to do another one together and maybe keep it simple instead of writing a whole thing? So if I give you the word Nasir, okay, first of all, who can tell me the meaning of Nasir?
Helper.
So next time if you see somebody with the name Nasir, that means that person is, in Arabic, somebody who helps somebody is called Nasir. What is Nasir?
Help.
Nasir is help. Are the root letters the same?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. If I say Nasrullah, what is that?
Allah's help.
Allah's help. Okay. So Nasir, I want to know Wahid. And somebody can help me with Rafa.
Nasirun.
Okay. Nasir.
Nasiran.
Jar.
Nasirin.
Good. Okay. Musanna.
Nasirani.
Yes.
Nasiraini.
Sorry, it's hard to write. Nasiraini. Okay.
Nasiraini.
And then the same thing. So what is Nasirani? Two male helper. Nasiraini, again, still two male helper, but in the, as objects. Nasirani as subject, Nasiraini as object.
Yes.
Now, Jama. Is it going to be Jama Salim or Jama Mukaffar?
Jama Salim.
Why?
The quality of it.
It's a quality. So what are we going to do?
Nasiruna.
Okay. Nasiraini. Nasiraina. Okay. Muslimina. So Nasirina. Nasirina. Right, Brother Kabir. Okay. So what is Nasiruna? More than two.
Plural, yeah.
Plural,
more than two, meaning three, cannot be two. Because in Arabic, we have Musanna by itself. So dual is there. So Jama is more than two. Nasiruna. Okay. Now, we're doing this example. Is it making the concept clear in your mind?
Yes.
Okay. If I have to say the female Nasir, how would I say that?
Nasiratun.
Nasiratan, Nasiratin. Nasiratani, Nasirataini, Nasirataini, Nasiratun, Nasiratin,
Nasiratin.
Making sense? Okay. Now, instead of me writing the whole thing, let me ask you another one. Okay. There is a word called Munafiq. Okay. So, each one of you, let's say one by one, I don't know which one, whoever is going to get an easy one and somebody. Let's start with Brother Afzal.
Munafiq one.
Let me give him easy
one. Easy one. Yeah. Munafiqun.
So give me all three.
Munafiqun, munafiqan, munafiqin.
MashaAllah. Musanna, brother Rafa, Arfa.
Munafiqani.
Munafiqani. Munafiqaini.
Munafiqaini.
Munafiqaini. Brother Abdul Jama.
Munafiquna.
Sorry, brother Lutaf.
Munafiquna, munafiqina, munafiqina.
Munafiqina. Now, how many times you have seen this word in the Quran?
Many times.
Many times. So now you, alhamdulillah, you understand. Okay. If the word comes munafiquna, that means those are the subject. Those are the subject in the status of subject. If it's munafiqina, then they're in the object or in the status of nasab. Okay. That one is done. Now, let me get some help from the sisters. Okay. So I have munafiquna. So who can tell me the female of munafiq? So I need wahid. So sister, let's see. Sister Noor, can you give me the female of munafiqatun?
Munafiqatan.
Munafiqatan.
Munafiqatin.
Munafiqatin. MashaAllah. Good job. Sister Nosheen, Musanna for munafiqa.
Munafiqatani.
Munafiqatani.
Munafiqataini. Munafiqataini. Sure.
Very good job. Very good job. Okay, let's see. Where is other people? Sister Fazilat. Munafiq, female, Jama Salim.
Munafiquna,
female.
Munafiqatani.
Munafiqatun.
Munafiqatuna. Munafiqatina.
Munafiqatun. Munafiqatin. Munafiqatin.
Jama?
Jama Salim for Munafiqa. For female Munafiq. So, Munafiqatun. Munafiqatin. Munafiqatin. Okay, very good job. Okay, so the next word I have is Sabir. Sabir. So how do I write it? The right Sabir. Sabir. What is the meaning of Sabir?
Patient.
One who has patience.
Now, man or female?
Man.
Man.
Yeah.
Okay. So sister, I think next on the list is Sister Isra. Would you like to do it? Sister Isra, would you like to do it? Oh, okay. Okay. Sister Sajida, would you like to do Sabir, the Wahid?
Yes. Sabirun.
Sabirun.
Sabiran.
Sabiran.
Sabirin.
Sabirin. Jazakallah. Okay. Who else is there? Brother Fawad, could you do the Musanna of Sabir?
Yeah, Sabirani, Sabirani, Sabirani.
MashaAllah.
Wow, that was quick.
You see that? This is what I'm looking for. Brother Kabir, Jama for Sabir.
Sabirun.
Sabiruna.
Sabirina.
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 Sabirina. Is this Brother Kabir or Brother Abdul?
This is me, Abdul. Okay. I just took advantage of a little quiet zone, you know.
Okay, no problem. Sister Nusrat, the female of Sabir.
Sabiratan.
Sabiratun. Sabiratun.
Sabiratani. Sabirat.
Okay. I'm only looking for Wahid for you. So give me Wahid for Sabira.
Sabira.
Sabiratani. Sabiratun.
Sabiratun. Sabiratan.
Sabiratin. Okay, very good job. So, who can give me the Musanna? Let's see. Umar, you want to give me the Musanna of Sabira? Rafa, give me Rafa Nasabinja.
Sabirani.
No, Sabira. Musanna.
Sabiratani. Sabiratani. Sabirataini. Sabirataini.
MashaAllah. Very good job.
So Musanna Muannas, right?
Musanna is dual. And I was asking for Sabira, which is Monmas. So sister Obeta, okay. Could I ask you for the Jama of Sabira?
Sabira female or male?
Okay, Sabira is female, right? I need the Jama Jama Salim for Rafa Nasab and Jama.
Jama Salim Sabira Sabira Tuna.
Sabira Tun.
Sabira Tun.
Yeah. Look at this. Yeah. You see that for the female is the Tun.
Yes, Sabira Tin.
Sabiratin, Sabiratin, Sabiratun, Sabiratin, Sabiratin. So the sound is ending sound for female for Jama Salim is Atun, Atin, Atin. So when you're looking at Sabira, which is like this, Sabira, right?
Yes.
So you're going to say Sabiratun. Sabira.
Okay.
In, and same thing for the jet. Okay.
Yes.
So inshallah, if did I cover everyone? I think my sister Zahra is still there and a few other people. So let me see if I can find another word. Okay. Okay. So there is another word called Hafiz. 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 So what is sorry, can you see it?
Yeah.
Sister yes. Zahra, could you try the Wahid Nasab Jar Rafa Nasab and Jar? Hafizun.
Hafizatun. No.
Male.
Hafizun.
Hafizun.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Hafizun. Hafizin.
Yeah.
Making sense? Hafizun Rafa, Hafizan Nasab, and Hafizin Jar. Brother Majid, are you there?
Yes, sort of. Assalamu alaikum.
Sort of.
Because I'm not totally into it a little bit, but I'll try.
Okay, well, sort of. Could you help me with the Musanna? Of Hafizun?
Hafizani.
Hafizani, mashallah. And this is Rafa. What is the Nasab and Jar?
Hafizani.
Hafizani.
Huh?
No. Zaini. Hafizaini. Because it's Musanna.
Hafizaini.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you are there, sort of. So, inshallah. can you please stay with us? And not just sort of, I guess.
Yeah.
It's just joke. I'm just teasing you. Jazakallah khair for participating. Sister Asia.
Yes.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah.
Okay. So Hafizun, what will be the Jama Salim? Rafa.
Hafizat.
No, Jama, it's a male, it's a male, it's a man. So Hafi,
Zuna.
Hafi, Zuna.
Hafi, Zuna.
Very good job. What would be the nasab of it?
Hafi, Zaina.
Very good job, mashallah. What is the meaning of Hafiz?
The protector.
Protector, mashallah. Very good job. So inshallah, you see, if we do this practice, inshallah, you will start to understand this and it will become easier and easier in your mind. Okay. So what is the time right now? 10:30. Okay. I want to do a quick concept, a new concept, and it is related to status. Okay. And tell me something. If we are able to change something, what do we call that? That thing we're changing, if it's changeable, then that means that thing is flexible. Yes? If we can change something, and the thing we are changing is able to change, then that thing is called flexible. And if you are trying to change it and we cannot change it because it's not capable of changing, then what is the English word for that?
Inflexible.
Not flexible. Or non-flexible, right? So what we have learned so far? We learned that Arabic noun has three statuses. Rafa, Nasab, and Jar. Yes?
Yeah.
So far, the nouns we have looked at, they were able to go in all three statuses. Yes? So those were all flexible nouns. What were they?
Flexible.
Yeah, so the people of Arabic language, they thought about that and they divided the nouns in two categories. One of them, they call it flexible. Okay, and the next one, they call it non-flexible. The good news is 98% are flexible. Only 2% are non-flexible. Okay, now I don't want you to wreck your mind on this, on your brain on this, and thinking that, oh my God, what do I have to learn now? No, simple in plain English, just stick with me. I have a noun, some of them are flexible and some of them are non-flexible. Luckily, 98% of them are flexible and only 2% are non-flexible. Okay? So which one is easier to learn? The 98% or 2%?
2%.
2%. In the non-flexible category, this is the end. We have nothing else after that. But in the flexible, we have further two categories. One of them are fully
flexible,
which is 87%.
Yeah.
And then there are partially flexible. And these are 13%. Okay, and I don't expect you to remember these percentages. I'm just telling you some information. Okay. What is the most easy way to understand non-flexible? If it's non-flexible, that means they cannot change. Can't change. Yes? How many status we have in noun?
Rafa, Nasab, Jar.
Rafa, Nasab, and Jar. If they cannot change, then what will happen? In Rafa, Nasab, and Jar, are they going to stay the same?
Yeah.
Same.
Okay. So I give you an example. If I say Musa. In the Quran, have you seen anywhere Musa, Musan, or Musun, Musan, and Musin? Have you seen Musun, Musan, Musin?
Mm-hmm.
No, they're always going to be Musa, Musa, Musa. Similarly, Isa, Isa, Isa. Similarly, if I have a word called Haza, it's always going to stay Haza. It's not going to change from Hazun, Hazan, Hazin. Making sense? Allazi, Allazi, Allazi. So what do I want you to learn from this? That any noun which cannot change or which stay the same in all three statuses is a non-flexible noun.
So brother Abid.
Yes.
So you mean Ism Ishara, all Ism Ishara are non-flexible?
Not all.
When you mention Haza and yes. Allazi.
Yeah, because this is a Wahid. And if you want me to be very specific, the Ism Ishara Wahid and Jama are Mabni, which is non-flexible. The Arabic name for non-flexible is Mabni. Mabni. Okay? And for the flexible, the name is Maurab. Okay. So you answer the question, Haza for Wahid and Haza Jama Talim, they are going to be Mabni. Haza Musanna will have all three statuses. It's going to be Haza, Hazani, Hazaini. Since we are so fresh with the Musanna, the dual of Haza will be Hazani. Yes. And the Nasabanjar will be Hazaini. Okay. What will be the Jama of Haza?
Haulai.
Haulai. Okay. Is it Jama Salim or Jama Muzakkar? Mukassar. So it's going to be Haulai, Haulai, and Haulai. It's going to stay same. So in order to answer my brother last question, yes, Isme Ishara, when is Wahid and Jama Salim, it's going to be all three, no change. However, if it's Musanna, then it's going to be flexible. Okay? So, can you tell me what is the simple example or simple definition of non-flexible? That in the all three statuses, they stay the same. Can you guys repeat?
Brother, can you repeat that Isme Ishara Musanna is flexible and Isme Ishara and Wahid?
Okay, Isme Ishara in the Wahid category and the plural category is non-flexible.
And Haza, that's Jama. Haza. That's Jama Salam.
Jama Salam is Haulai.
Okay.
Okay. In the Quran, you will see Haulai as always as Haulai.
Okay.
You're not going to see any change in the three status. Okay. So if you are okay with the non-flexible, I want to quickly tell you what the partially flexible and fully
question,
flexible.
Brother Abed, question yes. On non-flexible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Will it be, it will be always be Musa, not like, or Isa, or Haza, so it's what they call Fata sound?
Yes, it is not going to change the status by changing, you know, the sound. It's always going to be Haza, Haza, Haza. In all three statuses,
it will be Fata be Haza, sound, not Kasra, not any other, right?
No. That is why we are calling them non-flexible. And they're only 2%. And we will learn them by experience. I cannot give you a rule other than that you may have to memorize these words. There is a list of words which we can. So they're not too many. So it's very easy. So in the Quran, next time if you say Haza, 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 that means with the context of the sentence, you have to figure out whether it's the Rafa,
yeah,
or it's the Nasab or Jar. Yeah? So if I quickly go to the next one, the partially flexible. They will have only two statuses, which is Rafa, Nasab, and Jar. So partly flexible, they will change two statuses. Okay, fully flexible,
three statuses,
all three. And we have been doing the exercises for this all this time. So what will be the partially flexible? I give you some examples. If I say Ibrahimu, Ibrahimu, then it's going to be Ibrahima, Ibrahima.
Nasab and Jar are going to be same.
Yes. So in the Nasab and Jar, the only status they change is from Rafa. It's not Ibrahimun, Ibrahiman, Ibrahiman, or Ibrahimin. Yes. So some of these categories I will discuss next time. So you need to know this, that some of these names, Ibrahima, and some name like ending in An, like Usman, Imran, you know, those, and Umar, these names, and the names of the female, Arabic female names, they're all partly flexible. The name Arabic for these is Munsarif. Munsarif. And Ghair Munsarif. Okay. on a high level, if I ask you next time, please explain to me the flexibility of noun. This is the following answer you're going to give me. You are going to say that noun is of two types, flexible and non-flexible. Flexible is 98% and non-flexible is only 2%. In the non-flexible category, all three statuses are the same. There is no change whatsoever. And in the other category, flexible category, we have to divide them further into partially flexible and fully flexible. Fully flexible is simple because in all three statuses will change. And we learned the rule already that when we are dealing with a wahid and mukassar, we know the rule. When we are dealing with musanna, we know the rule. When we are dealing with jama salim, muzakkar and muannas, we know the rule. In partly flexible, we have to deal with 13% of the nouns, and they are only going to change two statuses. Rafa and Nasab and Jar will be the same. So Ibrahimu, Ibrahima, Ibrahima. Fatimatu, Fatimata, Fatimata. Umara, Umaru, Umara, Umara. Usmanu, Usmana, Usmana. There is a categories of these words. We will discuss them in the next class. Inshallah. Okay? Okay, so who can tell me, like whatever I just said, who can repeat after me, or who can tell me the answer? What can somebody explain to me the concept of flexible and non-flexible?
Flexible has got all three status, and well, that's fully flexible, and the partially flexible has got two status.
Okay, and then what is the non-flexible then?
Which are same in all three, Nasab, Jar, and Rafa, you know.
Okay, very good. All right. So who else can tell me in the way I was saying, that the way I said in English, can somebody give me a detailed answer? Brother Kabir, would you try that?
Yeah. So there are two types of nouns. Muarrab means flexible, and mabni means non-flexible.
Very good.
In a non-flexible, all the three status, rafa, jar, and nasab and jar are all same. We are not going to change. So it's going to stay. Like you gave the example of Musa, 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 mm-hmm. or Haza, Haza, Haza. And as you mentioned, that is for Issa Mashara, Wahid, Muzakkar. Then in Monna's case, it's going to be different. It's not, it's flexible. And on the other side, the flexible, where the two types of flexibility are fully partial, is going to change in the Rafa state is different, and Jar and Nasab state is different. So there are only two status. One is Rafa. Mm-hmm. And fully flexible is all the three statuses are different.
Very good job. MashaAllah. Jazakallah khair, brother Kabir. Okay. Sister Zahra, did you get this concept?
Sorry?
Did you get the concept of flexible and non-flexible?
Yes.
Okay. Sister Fazilat, can you explain to me high level what is non-flexible? It looks like she's busy. Umar, you want to tell me what is non-flexible?
Non-flexible is when the halat will stay the same. So it will be the same throughout.
So there will be no change whatsoever. Yeah. Okay, good job. So what is partially flexible then? Umar. Partially flexible.
Partially flexible is that, like, is it depending on, like, the situation, the halat will change depending on
not on the situation. Only the sentence. Two statuses. They will only have two statuses. The
rafat. Oh yes, the rafat and the nasab and jar.
Nasab and jar will stay the same. Okay, yeah. Very good. Jazakallah khair. Okay, so we're almost out of time. Okay. So let me stop this share. Yes. Anybody has a question?
No, sorry, brother. I was talking somewhere else. I should mute myself.
I have a question. What is the, is there any difference between Morib you said and there is another Munsarib? Are they the same thing?
Okay, so the top category, mm-hmm. we said we have flexible and non-flexible.
Mm-hmm.
The flexible name for Arabic is Morib.
Morib.
Inside the Morib category, we had the partially flexible and fully flexible. Yes?
Oh. Okay.
So the fully flexible are Munsarif and the partially flexible are Ghair Munsarif.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, all right. So let me see if I can share my screen again with you. Okay. Now.
I have a question about the Ghair Munsarif.
Jesus.
The only, you said like the only status will be changed is the Rafa. And it won't affect on Nasab and Jar, right?
No. The Nasab and Jar will be the same.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Like okay. only yes. the Rafa will be changing.
Yes.
According to the situation, right? Yes.
And it will not have a Tanween. It will have only one Dhamma. So that is another thing I forgot to tell you. It's not a Tanween. On certain names, it will be only one single Dhamma and not Ibrahimun. Remember, if Ibrahim is Wahid,
yeah.
But because it's Ghair Munsarif, we cannot say Ibrahimun. I will say Ibrahimu all the time. And next time when you're reading Quran,
uh-huh.
inshallah, pay attention to this. Whenever the name of brother, Ibrahim, whenever the name of Prophet Ibrahim is mentioned, it's going to be Ibrahimu or Ibrahima.
So this Ibrahimu is the
in the case of when he is the subject and Ibrahima when he is the object or there is some relationship.
Okay.
Okay.
So that's the rule of the thumb then for this particular status?
Yes.
Okay.
So next time I would say, please look at the verse. Ibrahim alayhi salam name is mentioned quite a bit in the Quran. Musa, Isa, you will find them, they're Mabni. They will not change. They'll always be Musa. Okay. Isa. Ibrahim. Okay. Usmana. Okay, but if we have another word called Zaidun, so Zaidun will be Zaidun, Zaidan, Zaidin. So, inshallah, we'll look at these categories next time.
Brother Abbas?
Yeah.
Is these like, you know, Ibrahim and Usman and all those names are non Arabic, right?
Yes.
And then the others are the Arabic names, they are like, they are non flexible?
Yes.
They won't change.
Yes.
Only the non-Arab name are like...
Yes, you're right. So those categories, we will go in detail in the next class. In the meantime, if you guys can catch up on my lecture about flexible and non-flexible, I had a pretty detailed lecture on that. And also the material I have been sharing with you, I don't know how you guys keep it together, but if you have it, you should have it in your notes. This information should be in your notes again. Okay. So these slides or these images I have sent you, please spend some time and try to remember these. Okay. So this one is pretty simple. The next one was Sagir, Sagirun, Sagiratun, Kabirun, Kabiratun, Zakiyun, Umun or Amyun or Umyun, Ummatun, Jamilun, Jamilatun. These are very good words to remember or understand because we use them quite a bit. So male, female, Zakiyun. Zakiyun means intelligent, but this is a male gender. MG means male gender. Okay, so please remember these words. These are vocabularies. If you don't, then it will be hard for you to, inshallah, craft the concept. So this was the table where Sister Noor figured out that this is wrong. Yes, it's supposed to be Muslimatun. So this is a chart for you guys to look what we have been dealing with. And then this is another chart. And I am leaving this with you as an exercise. So you need to do all of these words in your own time on a piece of paper, the way I showed it to you. Try to do as many as possible for both male and female and making the dual and the plural. Okay, so when you do that, can you guys share your photograph of that paper in WhatsApp group saying that, Brother Abid, this is what I did? Like a homework. So next class is on when? Thursday. So on Thursday, can I expect to see at least 3 or 4 variation of these things?
Inshallah.
Okay. All right. This one is also very important, right? You can see these are to do more with the relationship, like father, mother, spouse, man, woman, brother, son, child. So this is pretty good detailed list. Also, it has some mukassar, si kalamun, aklamun, kitabun, kutubun, ghurafa. Now, what is ghurafa? Ghurafa is a room. Inshallah, next time when you read Quran, this word ghurafa will come when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining Jannah, that there will be rooms for the people of Jannah. So ghurufun is one way to say the jama. Ghurufun means rooms. Ghurafa is room. Ghurufun is the jama mukassar. Ghurafatun, jama salim, muannas. So ghurafa is muzakkar or muannas? Is muannas, right? Ghurafatun, because there is tamal buta, right? Okay. Kalimatun, kalimatun. Qaryatun, Quran. So Qaryatun is town, like a village. Makanun, amakinun. So these are the jama mukassar examples. Okay. Let's look at this one. Again, rafa nasab jar for male and for the female. Muslimun, musliman, muslimin. We just did this. Muslimani, muslimaini, muslimaini. Muslimuna, muslimina, muslimina. Muslimatun, muslimatan, muslimatin. Muslimatani, muslimataini, muslimataini. Muslimatun, muslimatin, muslimatin. Now, I can tell you this much, that just by repeating it verbally, you know, orally, it will help you understand the concept.
Okay, one question, excuse me. Okay. Yeah. The chart that the homework that we're getting, is it this particular chart, this kind of chart we have to create for you?
You can create a chart like that, yes.
Okay, jazakallah.
Yeah, please do that because it has both the number and the status. So, yeah, that's a good example for a chart. That will be nice. Yeah?
Okay, jazakallah.
Okay, guys, it's 11:03. Inshallah, I'll let you go. We couldn't do the ayah today, or the verses. Inshallah, we'll do it on Thursday. And jazakallah khair for coming and participating. And I am hoping that we're all making a lot of progress.
Inshallah.
Inshallah. Keep me in your prayers. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa
barakatuh. Jazakallah khair for
Assalamu alaikum.